Hey there everyone, Ramesh here, back again with another video. In this video, I just wanted you to inform that I have just published a source code of employee management system project on my GitHub profile. And if you can see here, just few minutes back I have published the source code of employee management system project on my GitHub repository. Okay, and employee management system project I have developed using Spring Boot, Spring Security, Timelip, and MySQL database. So this project has two modules. One is employee management module and another is a registration and login module. So if you want to develop this project from the scratch, line by line coding, then you can go through these YouTube video series. So I have already published all these videos on my YouTube channel. You can go ahead and you can watch these videos to develop employee management system application from the scratch. All right, so this project is helpful for final year students. Final year students may take this project as their final year project or as an internship project. Well, this is a pretty much simple project, but you can make this project as a mid-sized project. So at the end of the video, I'm going to suggest you how you can, what are the features you can add to this project to make this project as a mid-sized project, and which you can use as your final year project or internship project. Let me show you the demo of this project. Well, this is the login screen. So if you enter localhost colon 8080, then you will navigate to the login screen. Alright, so before signing or login to the employee management system, we have to register first. Okay, as you are a new user, click on register here link and you can register to this application yourself. So basically, admin user will basically manage the employees by using this employee management system. Well, let's say first name is admin and let's say last name is also admin, and email ID like admin@gmail.com and password let's say admin, and hit the register button over here, and there we go. The admin user successfully registered to employee management system application. Now just click on login here link and you will navigate to the sign in page here. Just log in using email ID and password that just we have registered to this application. The email ID we have used is admin@gmail.com and password is admin. Well, go ahead and click on login button over here and there we go. We successfully logged in to employee management system. So admin user basically create the employees and manage all the employees by using this application, and here is a logout button. So admin user can log out from this application by clicking on logout link over here. So let's go ahead and let's add some employees. Let's say employee one, last name let's say employee one, and email ID let's say employee@gmail.com, and let's create few more employees so that we can also see the pagination and sorting features. Employee2@gmail.com and hit save button. Let me quickly create few more employees so that we can able to see the pagination and sorting. Okay. Now we have created 5 employees, right? Now let's go ahead and let's create one more employee called employee6, and last time let's say employee6. I'm just giving a dummy details here. You can give the real employee post name, last name, and email ID, and there we go. As soon as we create 6 employees, we can able to see here the pagination. Okay, so we are basically showing 5 employees in a first page, and if you can click on 2 here, you can able to see a second page. Over there you can see only one employee. Alright, so I have, you know, implemented a pagination for this project. And to do sorting, what you can do is you can just click on the column. For example, let's sort the employee by employee post name. So just click on employee post name and you can able to see here the URL. The sort field is first name and the sort direction is in descending order. If you want to sort employees by post name in ascending order, you can just go ahead and click one more time here and you can able to see the URL. Sort field first name and sort direction ascending. Similarly, you can sort the employees by employee first name, last name and email ID. Alright, so these are the features, guys, I have implemented in this project. And you can go ahead and you can update one of the employee. Let's say I want to update this employee one. Okay, the spelling is not correct, right? So let me click on update here and let's say employee one. Okay. So here I'm going to update first name, last name and email ID. Click on update employee and there we go. Alright, you can also delete the employees by using delete button here. Alright, so these are the features like add employee, update employee, delete employee and paginate employees and sorting employees. So these are the features I have implemented in this project and user can click on logout button to logout from the application. Alright, so now this project seems like pretty simple project, but you can extend this project you know, by adding few more features to this project. For example, let me log into this project one more time. And here what you can do is, in order to extend this project, you can create a few more modules to this project. So department module, you can go ahead and you can implement a department module. So you can add a tab over here like department module. And once you click on department module, you can able to see the departments list here. So similar to employees list, you can create a departments list and you can, you know, create a button over here like add department instead of add employee. And you can update the department and delete the department. So take this as an exercise and just go ahead and implement a department module in this employee management system. Okay, so while adding the employee, you can also add one selection box here and you can just select the department while adding a employee. So one to many relationship, one department can have multiple employees. For example, in IT companies, you know, department, there are different departments, right? Like R&D department, financial department, HR department, etc. So multiple employees can belong to R&D department or HR department or financial department, like that. So you can go ahead and you can implement you know, department module, and while adding an employee, you can provide a selection box here and you can select the department the employee want to belongs to. And apart from that, you can also create a project module and you can assign that project to the employee. So in this way, you can keep on adding the modules to this project so that this project becomes a pretty much, you know, mid-sized kind of project. Alright, just go ahead and first try to you know, implement the department module in this project. Alright, now let's come back to the source code of this project. What you can do is you can go ahead and just clone the source code of this project, or you can directly download the source code of this project by using download zip button over here. Alright, so once you download this project on your file system, then you can go ahead and unzip it and then you can import in your Eclipse ID or STS ID. For example, so look at here, this is my STS ID and I have already imported employee management web app in my STS ID. So in this way, you can go ahead and you can import this project in your Spring tool suite ID. So in order to import this, what you can do is you can go ahead and click on file here and then click on import and choose existing my own projects, and then you can go ahead and you can, you know, provide the file system path over here, okay, and choose the form.xml and hit finish. So the project was already imported in my workspace, so that's why I am getting this warning. Okay, in your case you will successfully import this project in your Spring tools or tidy. So once you successfully import it, then what you need to do is go to the application.properties file and look at here demo. So demo is our database name. You can go ahead and create a database in your MySQL workbench. For example, I have just created a demo database by using this SQL statement, that is create database followed by name of the database. Okay, so once you create the database, then you can go ahead and run the Spring Boot project. So this is the Spring Boot main class and this is the entry point class of our project. So right click on it, run as Spring Boot project. So these are the steps you need to follow in order to set up this project on your local machine. Okay, so look at here, our Spring Boot application is up and running in embedded Tomcat server on port 8080. Now you can go ahead and just hit the link localhost colon 8080 in a browser and hit enter. You should navigate to the login screen and then you can go ahead and register and you can log in and you can manage the employees. Alright, I hope you followed the steps how you can, you know, run this employee management web app project on your local machine. So go ahead and download, okay, this is the first step, and unzip it and open your Spring Tools suite ID and go ahead and import this project by using import option here. And once you import, then what you need to do is you need to go to the application.properties file and this is the name of the database, that is demo. And before running your Spring Boot application, you should have to first create a demo database in MySQL Workbench. Otherwise, you will get an error, okay, like a database not found error. So once you create a database, that is demo database, then you can go ahead and run the Spring Boot project by using this Spring Boot entry point main class. Okay, this has a main method, so you can run this project as a standalone project. So once you successfully run this project, then you can able to access this project by using URL localhost colon 8080. Alright. Well, if you want to develop this project from the scratch, then I highly suggest you guys to, check out these videos. Alright, so in order to implement employee management module, that is add employee, update employee, delete employee, and list all the employees, pagination, sorting, then you need to watch these 7 videos. And if you want to implement a registration and module feature, then you can watch these video series. So these series I have already published on my YouTube channel. You can go ahead and click on this link. Perfect. And this project is very helpful for especially students to have some kind of hands-on experience. And as I already suggested, you can add a few more features and modules this project to make this mid-sized project, and you can use it as your final year project. Okay, great. You can follow me on GitHub. Okay, so whenever I will publish this kind of projects on my GitHub profile, you will get notified. Okay, just go ahead and follow me so that whenever I will publish such projects on my GitHub profile, you will get notified. And look at here my paid course. So you can go ahead and check out my paid course. The 25% discount still available for next few days. So you can go ahead and check out, building real-time REST APIs with Spring Boot course. All right. I hope this project you will find useful, and subscribe to my YouTube channel whenever I will publish this kind of projects and my GitHub profile, I will make a videos and you will get notified if you subscribe to my YouTube channel. And yeah, I will see you in next video with another useful content. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.